Hey, it's SGU, and welcome back to my MLB The Show. Well, now 17 Atlanta Braves Franchise Mode series. We ported it over from MLB The Show 16, making our debut in MLB The Show 17 with the Atlanta Braves franchise. Of course, wanted to continue this one. We've got a good rebuild going on. As a matter of fact, we're holding on to first place in the NL East, and it's after the All-Star break. Now, looking at the new menu here, and as will happen porting these rosters from year to year, we tend to lose a player or two who's been renamed and reassigned and what have you. But this time around, it's Reggie Tackett. Who is Reggie Tackett exactly? Well, it turns out that was Manny Banuelos, and he's been renamed for whatever reason, not a part of the roster move. So that was a little weird, but you look at our options of playing games this year, and I kind of like this. You can play the full game. You can go ahead and sim or whatever you want, but this year you can player lock and you can quick manage. We're going to be looking at both of those options in this video as fun ways to kind of spice up the way we present our franchise modes. And we're going to start off by doing a player lock, which means we're essentially doing a road to the show style, following one player through the game. But the great thing is you're not locking that for the season. And of course, even with a season lock, you could change it around. But this is very accessible. You just jump in with your favorite player or your featured player, and you go to it for the day. And this is going to be our debut at SunTrust Park. Yeah, okay, a little weird that we're moving in the middle of the season, but that's how it's got to go. That's where we're at in our game save. So first game at SunTrust Park, as far as we are concerned, happens today. And there is the aforementioned Reggie Tackett, a.k.a. Manny Banuelos. I thought about trading him, but I'm like, yeah, you know what? We'll leave him there for now. It kind of bugs me that he's become a no-name player, if you will. But, okay, we're locked into Freddie Freeman today. We're down 1-0, and that is a base hit up the middle. Runner going to go from first to third on that. So a nice job by Freeman moving the runner along, and he's 1-for-1 in this game. They'll give us another look, and our first look at MLB Network presentation, at least in this series. Gotta love it. It's kind of nice you actually have three presentation choices in any one game here, but MLB Network, definitely the highlight package as it's brand new in here. But again, the show series about giving you options. They're not going to force you to use MLB Network presentation. They're going to give you choices of everything that they've come along with so far, and you can customize and go, and you'll have the look and feel of different broadcasts within your franchise. You see, we're going to fly out to left field right there. That'll end the sixth inning. But getting back to the presentation, that's a nice touch. You know, you go from regional broadcast to national broadcast throughout the season. So to have different elements of presentation for different games that you play is really a smart choice for them to go along. There is a ground out, and that would have been a chance right there if he were to have hit a home run to send the crowd home with a walk-off. If that doesn't happen, we're going to go extra innings, 10th now. They have a chance to score the run to the Mets, but 1-2, double play, ends the inning. How clutch is that right there? So the Braves get another chance to win this ball game. First, we see the inning ending. Double play in the top of the 10th. Flipped there from Swanson. Echevarria throws on over. Nice pick by Freddie Freeman, and we're good to go. And it looks like the Braves have walked this off as we see the post-game presentation celebration. Dansby Swanson, your player of the game, I'm guessing he came up with the game-winning hit right there. And Atlanta wins 3-2, keeping their grasp on that first-place spot in the NL East. Very surprising that our young squad is still being able to do that. So the next game up, you got Jacob deGrom pitching for the Mets. And what are we going to do here? Let's do another player lock. And hey, it was a player of the game last time out. Let's pick Dansby Swanson, and we'll highlight him today. Now, this is really cool, because so you're going to get different perspectives on the franchise by doing this. You get to see all the action in the eyes of Dansby Swanson, who's starting a double play of his own right there. Nice job doubling up Lucas Duda. Let's see another replay of that, or a replay of that, as you've got the hopper to second base. And Swanson is able to easily get this started with a backhanded flip. And they turn two. So nice job by the Braves right there out on the diamond playing defense. And now Swanson coming to bat, hitting 272 with 8 homers, 36 RBI so far on the season. Let's see if we can go ahead and up those numbers. We're down 1-0. You're going to go opposite field with this. Gets it high in the air. But it is going to be a routine catch out there in right field. Nothing doing for Swanson in that at bat. It'll stay 1-0 in favor of the Mets. We got a 1-1 game in the fourth, though, now, and another chance. And this one's rolled to short. Slow roller, and they get the force at second base. Inning is over. Dansby Swanson 0-2. Let's take it back out to the field in the fifth here. Chance to turn two. We got the hop throw, and yes, right on the money to Freeman at first base. And once again, a twin killing for the Atlanta Braves. Robbie Erlin appreciating that. Behind him now, you've got Cespedes coming to the plate for the Mets. Always a threat. He's already doubled in this game. His fifth inning at bat with a 1-1 count. Erlin the pitch, and this is going to be a chopper chasing in here. And Swanson goes ahead with the bare hand. I don't know if he needed to, but it sure looked nice. 2-1 Mets in the seventh inning, and we're chasing out of the zone. Not very good discipline right there. It's probably going to knock my dynamic hitting difficulty settings downward if I keep chasing pitches like that. Anyway, Swanson gets a chance in the ninth. 1-2 count. He will put it in play, but barely. Pitcher makes the play, and Swanson is out. This thing is looking like it's just about ready to be closed out by the Mets, and they do indeed get the victory. So they even this thing up here after losing the day before. The Mets take this one, and we have new outfield celebrations this year. A lot of variations going on out there, added to the mix. Braves are not very amused, however. They can't come up with the runs they need in this game, and they drop it 2-1. DeGrom is your winner. And the Mets even up the series. You see DeGrom's line for the game, 6 innings pitched, just 4 hits allowed. All right, so let's see who wins the rubber match here in the series against the Mets, and it is a doozy. Tehran versus Syndergaard. We're going to go ahead and quick manage this one to start off with. Want to check this out, and oh, right off the bat, not good. A triple and then a sac fly against Tehran in a first inning run. We get a single here. Now, okay, this is nice. Let's bunt him over, sac bunt. I kind of like how this is quick, but you can have your input into the decisions being made. You see a solo home run here later on. Was that 6th, 7th inning? And now we're going to try to make that run up. Syndergaard still in the game. And we got a runner on base. And this is where I'm going to jump in. So you can jump into the play, jump back out, and quick manage as many times as you want to. It's a very slick system. Shift is on. That ball's knocked down at third base. But there is no play at first by the time he finds the handle on it. Ruiz is safe. And how about those Braves alternates right there? Looking pretty sharp. That's going to be the end of the line for Noah Syndergaard. Thor will hit the showers. And maybe this is the momentum we'll need now here to break through as we've sent the starter to his exit. Let's see what we can do against the bullpen. You've got nobody out, and Freeman rips this with two runners on, but right at the first baseman. Bad luck right there. Get that down the line a little bit. Maybe run scores on the play instead. Now you're going to have a force out at second base that eventually ends the inning, and we get nothing out of our opportunity right there. It's still remains 2-0 Mets. Let's fast forward now to the ninth inning. And this pitch is going to hit Malik Smith. Ouch. Shake that off, young man, and take your base. That one got away. Hits him just below the kneecap, it looked like. But we do have a runner in the ninth inning, and that's exactly what we need because it brings the potential tying run to the plate. 2-2 count here with one out. This is Ruiz, runner going. He is going to put that one to left field, not stopping. Oh, my goodness. Oh, force him to make a good throw, but that's gutsy. Going to go from first to third when the ball hit fairly sharply to left field. You see them covering the bag right there. Not that the shortstop would have a play on that anyway, but a great job on the hit and run. So now we're in business. Do we go to the bench to get a pinch runner for the trail runner that would be the tie? If they come around, yeah, we're going to do that. Dansby Swanson comes off the bench. We had rested a lot of starters today because it was suggested that they were tired, some of them getting chances to come in here in relief roles. So once again, it is Freddie Freeman, but he's going to strike out. Oh, man, that's rough. We needed a big hit right there, and we didn't get it. 3-2 count with two outs. Runners moving, and that's going to be a grounder to second base. That's going to, oh, wow, that throw was not a good one, but nice pick there at first. The Mets hold on to it for Syndergaard. He gets the win, and the Mets take the series 2-1. What celebration do we have out here this time? All right. Very cool. Lots of variety, like I said, out there. But once again today, the run's hard to come by for the Braves. They drop it 2-0. They get shut out. So I like our new options here in franchise, the things that we can get doing. Next time, we'll take on the Pirates and beyond. Who do you want to see featured in Player Locks coming up? Let me know. We'll see you next time.